Okay, today we're going to be talking about abstract. Now, there's two different types of abstract. There's very precise abstract, and then there's just emotional abstract. Now, this first abstract that I did, it's pretty light, but it's in the style of Mondrian. You will recognize his work when you see it. But as you can see, it has very precise lines. Now, the importance with precise lines is that they have to be perfect. We've talked about perfect edges before, and even look how those little bristles are sticking out. This is a time when you're going to want to make sure that you have all those taken off there, because you don't want anything to ruin your lines. What you'll then do, load up your paintbrush with lots of paint, brace your hand, go on the very edge, press down till it gets to the outside,
and you let the brush edge
do the work for you.
Nice.
As soon as it starts doing that, it means that you ran out of paint. You gotta go back for it immediately. Now, with him, the big thing was having these really flat colors inside. There wasn't really any value variation at all. Now, you don't have to copy anybody's style exactly, but if you're doing it in his style, you're going to want to make sure that you get a really clear coat of paint on there with very little value. Now, a lot of people think, that looks easy, anybody can do that about abstract art. But after this project, you'll have a new appreciation just for how difficult it is to have things come out this perfect. I'm taking my time. I'm going nice and slow. You have to go right up to the edge. And all that just to paint one red square. Now, I don't want any brush lines in there, so I have to keep going back and forth over it until it looks just like flat color. Now, that's one style of abstract. Everything is very detailed and precise. Everything is lined out. Now, the other style of abstract is all about movement and how your brush goes on the page. That might be this. What is it? Doesn't matter. It's abstract. Okay, so don't be like, oh, I can tell what that is. No, you can't, because it's nothing. Now notice how I didn't even wash my brush. Colors just mixed together. That's fine. And I'm looking for how it flows on the page. You still want to think about emphasis and rule of thirds and all of the things that we've talked about, but instead of doing it with a picture, now you're just doing it with lines and shapes and colors.
And how do you keep it from making muddy brown? Because what if you mix colors on the page and they make muddy brown?
Muddy brown happens when you mix together a primary and its complement. Or when you mix all three primaries together, which would be the same thing.
Oh, I should have known that. We studied that before.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So you would want to clean your brush if you're going to another color.
And we're going to come back. We're going to let her work and come back.
So as you can see here, we've been working on this expressive abstract piece. You see a lot of different lines, a lot of different shapes, some dots, some patterns. Now, if you are going to insist on being the future Jackson Pollock, there's a right way and a wrong way to do it. First off, it doesn't really work great on this size paper. Those are meant to be seen like the full size of the wall. But if you are going to splatter, the best way to do it is to hold your brush real close and hit like that.
Oh.
That gives you just a little bit of splatter, but look at how not everywhere. Now you can also add a little water to the brush.
And just be careful when splattering, because kind of like glue, a dot is a lot. And
a lake is a mistake.
Yeah, too much is too much.
Now, if you have somebody sitting next to you that's doing this piece and you splatter their piece, they are going to be ticked off. So you want to make sure it's really controlled. A lot of times I recommend that the students put it in a cardboard box when they're doing this, so anything sticks on the edges. But that is the way to splatter. It's not just throwing your brush like this. Nice and controlled.
Miss Van Ness, yes. What do you call this piece of work? Do you have a title for this?
Ode to Odison. All right. So you see the two differences. One style, very flat, very precise, very perfect. If this is more your personality, go for it if you want to try this one. If this is more your personality, they both have positives and challenges. Positives, it's really easy to plan this one out. The difficulty is it's pretty hard to make sure it's precise enough. Hard thing about this one is you can't really plan it. You have to have a happy accident. If it doesn't go right, you have to make it work. But the good part is you can go a little crazy and be creative. Abstract painting.